Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about very interesting concept that is required for Kanban board in Jira. So if you are working into the Kanban board and you want to organize your backlogs and stuff for the development, you can make it easy by using one interesting add-on which is built by Technofor. So we'll show you how we can manage complete Kanban board through this add-on. When we are working with the Jira add-on, it's very easy to use it. So you have to simply click on app sections and from there navigate it to the download or find new apps options, and from here just write Kanban Combined WIP and hit enter. It will show up the Kanban Combined WIP for Jira Cloud. Here, select this and it will navigate it to this add-on, which is built by Technofor. So I will show you how we can configure and use it within our environments. What's the feature of this Kanban Combined Work in Progress for Jira Cloud? So this will combine columns and work in progress details. So by using this keywords, and after that it will also help us to set interactive background as an image and full color codes. After that, we can also add work in progress to swim lane, scroll or zoom the board. We'll show you how we can use it. On the security point of view, this is secured enough, and this is a partner has completed the security self-assessment program. So it means this is certified from the Jira point of view to use it for any enterprise. So without wasting time, let's jump into the main concepts. So from here, if you have not installed, just click on try for free. That will be available for 30 days. And after that, you have to pay for using more number of days. Now, once the installation will be done, you will find it out. Kanban WIP, once we'll click on this, this will navigate us to this page where we have to download this app and add into the Google Chrome. Click on continue and this will navigate it to for Chrome extensions. And this add-on is available in multiple browsers, just like Google Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and few others. That detail you can find it out from here. So for which browser it will support, you can see from the main page sections. Now, once we will add it, it will add to the extensions or Google Chrome extensions, and from here this will download it. And once this will be downloaded and added, you can see Kanban Combined Work in Progress for Jira Cloud. After that, just go to our projects, and from here we'll select our projects. And now one in progress by column, we can combine work in progress. We have to set it up. Now to set it up, simply click on these three dots, and from here navigate it to the board settings, and from columns you can see backlogs selected for development, in progress and done. Now if we want to see this complete board, we have to just status here to enable. Now board getting full, if we want we can use it. After adding this, let me add it. Now we have added this. After that, we have to again add this into dev in progress, and let me add one more column as UAT. So we have created dev selected for the development and dev which is in progress. So here when we navigate it to the board, go to the settings, and here dev selected for the development and dev in progress, minimum number 1 and maximum we can set it up 20. Let's say again 1. Max, I'm setting here 20, and that's it. Now once the configuration has been done, we will set it up the board settings, and if that looks fine, then probably we will navigate it to the board, and from the board sections you can see this dev part is combined. So selected for the development and in progress, both is showing in one board. And just because of the Kanban combined work in progress add-on, and you can see these two tables are showing. And this is a very interesting, if you want to combine work in progress limit for the grouped column, we can just select it and you can see the grouped column. If you want, we can just click on this and you can see the color codes. If we want to click on the collapse or expand, simply this will show us the collapse and expand field. Again, if we want to apply implicit policies, which is required, we can add it, add explicit policy, that is also possible to add it. But if you want to remove, just simply remove it. Now, if I want to add select background image, then probably we can add this background image, which is available. So let me add this as a background image. Background, so now if you can see here, the background color has been set. So other than that, we can also remove a person background image, which I don't want to use it. But if you want to select the background image again or change the background image, simply click on any of the images which we want to apply it. And once you click on save, and that image will be updated successfully. So this will look a very interesting when we are working with Kanban board. And here, if let's say I'm just dragging and dropping into in progress item, you can see this in progress item is showing here. Apart of that, we can also apply a scroll filter. So if I want to remove it, simply I will click on this and this will be removed successfully. Zoom in, zoom out option is also here, where we can apply the zoom in and zoom out image. Generally, when we are applying the background image or the selected image or removing the image, if we want, we can set our own image specifically. Even if we want to disable it, simply we'll click on this and this will be disabled successfully. So this is how we can customize our board and make it interactive or looks very interesting when we are working within our team. So this is how we can add personal background or setting the background image within our Kanban board. Adding a work in progress swim lanes, that is also possible. So when we are walking into the swim lanes, navigate it to the board settings, and from here, let's say I want to apply the swim lanes. So configure swim lane work in progress limits. So let's say I just want to apply the expedit 5 and everything else will be included here, which is required, everything else. So that is set. So here we have set that limit, and you can see this limit will be applied successfully. Now when I will navigate back to my board, and here I will be able to see this options. So let me refresh this page. Now let me move other items into the different field so that we can see the results properly. I'm just moving some of the items to the other column as well so that we can see the proper result here. So here, if you want the swim lanes to be applied, simply I will just uncheck this and this will be removed, and then we'll navigate it to the board settings, and from here we'll add this. So here we are having the highest priority set as not applied, that's why everything else is showing here. So let me set the issues priority. So let me update it to the, instead of medium, let me set it up highest. So this will become highest, and you can see the difference. Now again, I want this to be updated as highest, so you can see This is also showing. So whenever we are applying the statements, we have to make sure that data is evaluated properly. Otherwise, we won't be able to figure out the difference. When it comes to the color part, you can see the color codes, and whenever it is required, we can update the color codes accordingly. So if you can see here, the combined work in progress is showing in this. Collapse or expand field is showing here. Exactly same filters, and everything is available as per our required fields. So this is how we can apply the work in progress, combined work in progress Kanban board, or make it attractive for teams so that teams can work efficiently. Now let me remove this swim lane. So here I'm just removing, and now that's done. So maybe I will mark it as a not this, and here we have this background set it up. Once I'm removing the background, you can see how this looks. Now if you can see here in the priority sections, we also have the options highest, high, medium, low and lowish. These are the color codes or the card color codes. So that is also we can set it up. So here we will get all those line items in showing this, and probably let me move some of the items into this board, and then we will have the complete background image. So let me enable this, and if you can see here, we have the color codes applied. So based on the priorities also we can set it up the color. This is the color for the medium. Let me update this as a in some other fields like low, then this issue will looks like in blue color. So based on this add-on, we can also select the color codes or showcase the color codes on tile. So this is how we can use this add-on built by Technofor, which is used for managing and arranging Kanban board into any projects. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so this will be useful, don't forget to share your feedback within the comment sections. And if you have any suggestions or feedback, reach out to Technofor team for any product level feedback. Thank you for watching.